Carol Sullivan for the Galena Center for the Arts. Many of you have attended one of our Sunday salons and seen some amazing performances by classical musicians. Did you ever wonder, how do they do that? How do they do such difficult work and make it look easy? Or how do they play something simple and bring us to tears? And they do it over and over and over. We thought you might find it interesting to learn a little bit more about the musicians that have played for us in our Sunday salons. To help me with this today, John Woodin will be with us. John is not only a wonderful musician, but has been a good friend and a good friend to the Center for the Arts. So maybe John can help us learn classical musicians. What makes them tick? John?
Hi, everybody. My name's John Woodin, and I've been fortunate enough to be involved in something called Sunday Salons with the Galena Center for the Arts. I was really lucky that I got to perform with my family, and we got to have some live music at the Galena Center on a Sunday salon. So here with me today is one of the most important members of my family. This is Rob Woodin. He's coming to us from Boston. And Rob got to be part of that Sunday salon performance. And today we're going to talk about why live music is so cool, particularly in the Sunday Salon series. So Rob, obviously you're my son and I'm really proud of you, but talk to us a little bit about, if you can remember, what your very first live performance experience was when you were, I don't know, two or three, something like that.
Well, I don't remember two or three, but I remember when I was maybe six or seven and I performed with you on stage in Washington, Iowa at the Washington Community Theater. I'm not sure what that's what it's called, if it's Washington Players. But anyway, we did a production of Peter Pan and I was the littlest lost boy. And you were a horrible pirate. I don't remember what your name was, Poopa or something like that. Yeah, but that's my memory of my first performance.
So that was your first time in front of a live audience. What did it teach you? What did you take away from that? Did it give you the bug to, I want to do this again? Or did it scare you? Or
it wasn't scary. That? I think definitely the bug of performing live is really exciting and fun. The show must go on. If something hilarious happens on stage that's not supposed to, you gotta cover that mistake and move on. And keep giving the audience what they deserve as a fantastic performance. Even if...
classical guitar was about 10 years ago. I was a senior at Hempstead and there was a concert, was a free concert at Divine Word College with the Brazil guitar duo. Now it's two Brazilians from Sao Paulo and they had just recently won a couple competitions in Europe and Latin America and they were doing a tour around the United States and somehow, I don't know exactly how they got to Divine Word for free. Because those guys, they recorded Fioio Ma just recently. So yes. And at the time, as I forgot, Jim's Sherry wife, she worked there. And she sent a poster to Terry Slade, who got a hold of me. And then my mom called them and like, hey, my son's from Brazil and would love to come to see your concert. So they invited me to not only watch the concert, but to watch them practice and have dinner with them. Mm-hmm. They were very humble, and at the end of the concert, they dedicated a piece to me, and at the end of the concert, like, we're going to stay here all night practicing, you know, at the chapel, really nice acoustics for classical guitar. If you want, you can bring your little sleeping bag and just watch us do what we do.
Mm-hmm.
my sojourn into music was sort of like a strange route. It wasn't like one thing kind of kicked it off and I ended up going in that direction. It was a lot of little influences that kind of were like small stepping stones for me. When I was little, one of the earliest photographs of me that my parents had was me sitting in this rocking chair with these enormous headphones that were like the size of my head, and I'm sitting with a little John Denver record. So I grew up in the Detroit area, eventually found my way to Denver, and in Colorado it was like you listen to John Denver, it's just what you did. So he had this Rocky Mountain High album, and then he had another one that was with the Muppets, and I was obsessed with that. So that kind of budded my early interest in music. My parents
performance that really had an impact on you, something that made you go, wow.
Well, now, something that I was performing in, or?
Something maybe before you were performing.
Well, I just remember going to live performances as a very little kid and wondering what's going on here. And it was fascinating. And, you know, I had no idea anything like this, you know, happened in the world. You know, those first few performances are when you walk in the theater and people start singing and acting and dancing. And so that was, you know, that was, I remember that. I thought, wow, this is fantastic.
Of other performances under your belt, some operas, some musical theaters, a lot of individual recitals. I want to go into a little bit about what we did and you particularly did for the Sunday Salon in Galena. How do you, when you prep for a recital, how do you choose music? What do you know? What do you think about the audience? How do you choose what experience that audience is going to get?
A lot of factors go into choosing the best music for a performance. Mainly with this one, back when we performed in Galena, we needed to choose a very wide range of varying, contrasting performance of different tastes of style and expression. So we chose some art songs, some opera, some musical theater, and you know, kind of a general mix of duets and solos just to keep it interesting. And things that we felt that we could put together in a very short amount of time. We didn't have a lot of rehearsals since we were coming from different locations. You in Cincinnati and me in Boston, something that we could not necessarily throw together, but something that we could feel good about performing. We looked at some past things we'd done together before.
To talk about when you were preparing for the Sunday Salon concert that you gave in Galena. Mm-hmm. What went through your mind? How did you choose music? How did you get in the proper mindset for a live performance in Galena, Illinois?
Mm-hmm. The first time I played for Galena, I was just finishing grad school. So I was fresh out of the boat. You have repertoire that's really challenging to tackle. I played an entire Villa-Lobos concerto, a whole Bach suite. There was a 20th century guitar piece written for electric guitar, transposed. So the repertoire was really challenging that I was dealing with at the time. And I wanted to do some of that, but I also wanted to reach out to people who were still getting their ears used to the instruments, still getting their ears used to classical music, and just showcase what the guitar can do. I mean, the wonderful thing about the guitar is, like Andrew Segovia would say, it's like a miniature orchestra. You know, you can do. And so I tried to do a little bit of that. I did a little bit of Bach. I did a little bit of arrangements of my own, of tunes that are standards that everybody knows. I think that really helped. I also tried to play a little bit of, I'm from Brazil, so I played some of the traditional Brazilian music. Case, you know, you leave everybody happy. But, you know, putting a program together is almost like Stravinsky used to say, before you present the audience with something more deep, so to speak, you give them a lollipop, you know? So finding those spots in the program to insert the lollipop or to insert pieces that, okay, I know you're going to like this. After that, how about we listen to like a Bach fugue? And so on, you know.
Sunday Salon is a live performance. And that's what's so terrific about you get to choose the music that you're going to share for a live performance. Knowing what you know about Galena and knowing what you know about the area and the audience, how do you choose it? What kind of thinking went into choosing your program for your recent Sunday Salon?
I've done two Sunday Salons in the past. The first one I did, I think was like in April. We did it sometime in the month of April. It was early spring. And initially I was thinking about doing something kind of heavy with like a lot of heroines from opera that I was going to call it Twisted Sisters or something like that, and have kind of women that had gone crazy in opera. However, at the time our country was going through just a lot of chaotic things, and it felt a little heavy for springtime, and it felt a little heavy for just some of the things going on in the world. So I'm like, well, maybe a lighter program. So I ended up going with all music that was inspired by springtime and romance. And one of the things I always like to do in our neck of the woods, because it is an area that doesn't have a lot of opera, I always think about there's people there that really want to hear it, you know, even in a small area like Galena, even in a small area like Dubuque, and there's limited opportunities to do that. So I always try to program things that people are going to know, maybe that are familiar favorites that they've never had the opportunity to hear live. It is a special thing to be able to actually hear a singer sing a song live. I mean, there are arias that I've heard forever, and I hear different interpretations of them, and they still bring me to tears, even though I'm so familiar with them. So I always try to do something like that. The most recent one I did, I called it Back to Before. And I did sort of, because I love such a wide variety of music, I did very early Baroque arias all the way up to contemporary musical theater. I had some Jason Robert Brown. I had Ragtime, which is where that Back to Before came from.
There are people out there unafraid to feel sorrow, unafraid of tomorrow.
I'm going to ask you the difference emotionally between playing something that some schmo, I don't know, J.S. Bach or somebody that, you know, is sort of a composer, something that he wrote, and then something that David Resnick wrote, that David Resnick composed. What do you feel? How do you prepare? How do you gauge the audience? All that kind of stuff for something that's a David Resnick composition.
Well, I've enjoyed composing. And the teens were really good for me. I had a ballet in 2011 and 13 and 2015, and then I did a musical in 2017. And so there was a lot of David Resnick out there. But I guess when I play something like Bach or Mozart or some of the greats, I feel a great responsibility to do the best I can to recreate what that author was going for. It's really interesting to see what kind of connection my music has with the audience. It has a great connection with me. I see all the internal things. I try to put in a lot of emotion and movement and meaning. Now, what that meaning is, of course, you don't want to be too obvious about, but it has a lot of meaning for me, so I guess I'm waiting till it's all over and I talk to people who I know are listening, like Carol or yourself, and ask them to talk about the music. And I've found out that talking about music is one of the hardest things you have to do. And so when I teach a music course and say, well, let's talk about the music, everybody gets kind of quiet rather than I liked it or it was a fast piece or slow or whatever. But talking about music is challenging, even for those who are used to it and those who are paying attention. So I guess that's a long answer, kind of confining and high pressure for these fantastic performers, a little bit more into it as far as, and a lot more of me into my own compositions. And then hopefully connecting after the performance.
Thank you. one of the things our audience found so much fun when your family performed was that they got to also meet you. They got to not only be within touching distance of you while you were performing, but also afterwards, they could talk with you, and you were real people, as opposed to sometimes you see something on a stage in a big theater, and it's exciting because it may be live, but you don't feel like there's a human connection to the artist personally. So I think that was kind of fun too. I know a lot of people really enjoy that.
Well, we certainly enjoyed it. Our whole family had a great time with it. And what we've been talking about before we started the recording is the Salon series will be back. It's important mm-hmm. that people support the arts, local arts, live music, and doing it in the Salon series of the Galena Center for the Arts, that's pretty doggone important because you get to do the energy and have the fun of a live performance.
For the best! Faster? Why not?
Exactly.
What the colors are, the curse.
Are we in the